religion lives on from the Chippewa down of the big lake they call Gitche Gumee. The lake, it is said, never gives up pretty in the skies of November turn gloomy. With the load of iron ore, 26,000 tons more than the Edmund Fitzgerald weighed empty. A big ship and true was a bound to bitch when the gales of November came early. The ship was the pride of the American side, coming back from some mill in Wisconsin. As the big freighters go, it was bigger than most, with a crew and good captain well seasoned, concluding some terms with a couple of steel firms when they left fully loaded for Cleveland. And later that night when the ship's bell rang, could it be the north wind they'd been feeling? The wind and the wires made a tattle-tale sound, and a wave broke over the railing. And every man knew, as the captain did too, 'twas the witch of November come stealing. The dawn came late and the breakfast had to wait when the gales of November came slashing. But afternoon came, it was freezing rain in the face of a hurricane west wind. When supper time came, the old cook came on deck saying, fellas, it's too rough to feed you. The captain wired in, he had water coming in, and the big ship and crew was in peril. And later that night, when his lights went out of sight, came the wreck of the Edmund Fitzgerald. The searchers all say they'd have made whitefish pay if they'd put 15 more miles behind her. They might have split up, or they might have capsized. They may have rode deep and took water. And all that remains is the faces and the names of the wives and the sons and the daughters. Scenes in the rooms of her ice water mansion. Old Michigan steams like a young man's dreams. The islands and days are for sportsmen. And farther below Lake Ontario, it takes in what Lake Erie can send her. But the iron boats go as the mariners all know, with the gales of November remembered. In a musty old hall in Detroit, they prayed in the Maritime Sailors' Cathedral. The church bell chimed till it rained 29 times. Courage, man, on the Edmund Fitzgerald. The legend lives on from the Chippewa hometown of the big lake they call Gitche Gumee. Superior, they say, never gives up, redid when the gales of November come.